hearts from the poor and deep, let us praise the Lord.
Господи, Thank you. Prokion is in the second tone. The Lord is my strength and my song. He has become my salvation.
The Lord is my strength and my song. He has become my salvation.
The Lord hath chastened me sorely, but he hath not given me over to death.
The Lord is my strength and my song. He has become my salvation.
The Lord is my strength and my song.
He has become my salvation.
The reading is from the first epistle of the Holy Apostle Paul to the Corinthians. Brethren, all things are lawful for me, but not all things are helpful. All things are lawful for me, but I will not be brought under the power of any. Food is meant for the belly, and the belly for food, but God shall destroy both it and them. Now the body is not for fornication, but for the Lord, and the Lord for the body. And God hath raised up the Lord, and will also raise us up by his own power. Do you not know that your bodies are the members of Christ? Shall I then take the members of Christ and make them the members of a harlot? God forbid. Or do you not know that he who is joined unto a harlot is one body with her? For the two, saith he, shall be one flesh. But he that unites himself to the Lord is one spirit with him. Flee fornication. Every sin that a man doeth is committed outside the body, but he that committeth fornication sins against his own body. For do you not know that your bodies are the temple of the Holy Spirit, which dwelleth in you, which ye have of God, and ye are not your own? For you are bought with a price. Therefore glorify God in your bodies and in your spirit, which are God's.
Братья, вся милет суть, но не вся на пользу, вся милет суть, но не, а завладан буду от кого, брашно чрево и чрево брашном, Бог же, и сия и сия упразднит, тело же не блужению, но Господеви, и Господь телу, Бог же и Господа воздвижи, и нас воздвигнет силою Своею. Не вести ли, яко телеса ваша, удови Христовы суть, в земли уба, удовы Христовы сотворю, уды блудничны, да не будет, или не вести, яко прилепляся, сквернодеец, едино тело есть блудницею, будет обориче, оба в плоть едину, прилепляйся же, Господи, един дух есть, Господи, бегайте блудодеяния, всяк бог грех его жаще сотворит человек, кроме тела есть, а блудяй во свое тело согрешает, или невесте, яко телеса ваша, храм живущего в вас, святого духа суть, его же имати от Бога, и нести свои, куплены бои есть и ценою, прославите уба Бога в телесах ваших, и в душах ваших, и же суть Божия. И духови твоему. Аллилуйя, глас вторый, аллилуйя, аллилуйя, аллилуйя. Господи, спаси царя услышанный, вон же надлежащий день призовем Тебя.
Аллилуйя, аллилуйя,
my friend.
and sound, thou art ever with me, and all that I have is thine. It was me that we should make merry and be glad, for this thy brother was dead and is alive again, and was lost and is found. And she was for free to see you. Человек некий имеет два сына, и речею нищий отцу, отче, дашь мне достойную часть имения, и раздели имя имение, и не помнозит, не собрав всем, ни сына ты на страну далече, и ту расточи мне свое живы глубо. И жившу же ему все бы млад крепок на стране той, и той начат лишатися, и шед прилепись единого от житель твоя страны, и послай ему на села своя пасти свинья. И желаши насытить чрево свое от рожец, я же я дяху свинья, и никто же даяше ему. Себе же пришед рече, полико наемником отца моего, избивают хлебы, аже гладом гиблю, восстави дух отцу моему и реку ему. Отче, согрешил-то небо пред тобою, и уже не сам достойно решися, сын твой, сотвори меня по единому отдаемник твой, и восстави дух отцу своему, еще же ему далече сущу, узрей его отец его, и милый ему быстрый тех, нападе на выведи мою глаза его. Рече же ему, сын, отче, сам решил на небо и пред тобою, и уже не сам достойно решися, сын твой. Рече же, отец, рабом своим, изнесите одежду первую и облеците его, и дадите перстень на руку его и сапоги на ноги, и приведшите лес упитанный, да хвалите, яше веселимся, яко сын мой сей мертвел и оживел, из них был бед и обретеся, и на чаше веселите.
Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй.
Еще молимся великому Господи, Отце нашим святейшим, Патриархе Кириллу, Господи, нашему Серопресвященнейшему, Митрополиту Леоне, Патриархе Русской Зарубежной Церкви, Господи, нашему Преосвященнейшему, Архиепископе Петре, и все во Христе, братья наши.
Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй.
Еще молимся о стране всего сих, Господи, всех веру, благочестием, живущих дней.
Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй.
Еще молимся, благословенной стране России, и православных людей, Твоего Отечества, России, несущего спасения.
Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй.
Еще молимся Господу Богу нашему, еже избави люди свои драки, девок невидимую нашу, утвердите на мысли, братолюбие, благо, честие.
Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй.
Еще молимся, братья наши, священницы, священного наси, всему Христе, братстве наше.
Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй.
Еще молимся, блаженный Христа, памятный святейший, патриархи православный, благочестивый царь, многоверный царица, создатель святого храма, сего всех прежде почивших от всех и братьев, и лежащие повсюду православные.
Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй.
Стопы человеческие исправляй, Господи, извинился на рабы Твоя, и ангелы милодари мне, я солнце Твое, все путешествуй сюда, храма сего, и прости всякое помещение, вольно же невольно, благослови, благонамерение, совета и исходы, ходы со путешествиями справи, прилежно молимся, услышь и помилуй.
Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй.
Всякие скорби, для всякие болезни душевные.
Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй.
Еще молимся Господу и Спасителю нашему, еще храните в единении праве церковь православную, все мир пребывающий, даровать им мир, безмерную любовь и согласие, а церкви, Господи, услыши, помилуй.
Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй.
Thank you.
again and again in peace, let us praise the Lord.
Oh. Опоминет Господь Бог во Царстве Своем, всегда ныне пресно и во веки веков. Блаженнейшего Ануфрия, митрополита Киевского и всея Украины, испраждущую паству Его, да опоминет Господь Бог во Царстве Своем, всегда ныне пресно и во веки веков. В надежде воскресенья и жизни вечные рот своих, новопредставленных, митрополита Владимира, протоиерея Петра, протоиерея Иоанна, Мими, Елены, Владимира, да поминет Господь Бог во Царстве Своем, всегда ныне и пресно и во веки веков. Священство, монашество, всех големих и страждущих за веру православную, создателей и благотворителей, братьев, сестричества и поющих, святого храма сего и всех вас православных христиан, да поминет Господь Бог во Царстве Своем, всегда ныне и пресно и во веки веков.
Thank you. Of the dead and the life of the Let
Enlightened.
perhaps a little surprised that the church is clothed in vestments on this day, but that's because we're still celebrating the feast of the meeting of the Lord. Which again would make you question, why are the vestments blue? Because it's a feast of the Lord. In fact, it's called the meeting of the Lord, but it's really principally a feast of the Mother of God. And therefore, it's the practice in the Russian church to wear blue. For this feast and the after feast, which we are still in, the feast itself ends on Tuesday. Like most feasts, it has a forefeast and an after feast. Sometimes it doesn't have an after feast, because it's possible that this feast day could fall even during the first week of Great Lent, in which case we celebrate it on Forgive Us Sunday. Then there's no after feast. The after feast is frustration. Today, brothers and sisters, we hear one of the most important Gospels that we will hear in the entire year. Perhaps only rivaled by the Gospel of the Lord's Resurrection. We could argue that point. I don't want to argue that point. I would like to just have you accept that for now, and you can tell me later if you think that I'm wrong. Today we hear the parable of the prodigal son. As we were just discussing in the altar, many of the priests celebrate this as a sort of second namesake. When we come back to the Lord after having gone away. This is not some kind of mandatory sentence where everyone is expected or it's desired that you should do this. But the reality of the situation is that many of us who are here can very well identify with that prodigal son. Maybe not all the details of his life, but at least this idea that we grew in the church, we had a time when we were away, and when we came back, the Lord welcomed us, just as he welcomes the son in today's parable. I don't think it's necessary, in fact I think it would even detract, to go over the parable. I will say, if you don't understand anything in what I have said now, please read it when you get home. We pass out in the Good News Bulletin the reading itself. We also list it in the Sunday reading that you can grab when you come to kiss the cross. We also have it prominently displayed on our website. You can easily find the Sunday reading. And it's a good practice, I think, to read it when you get home, whether it's the Sunday of the Prodigal Son or some other Sunday, to review and think a little bit about what it is that the church is providing for us for our salvation on this day. Because that's what the Sunday Gospel reading is about. It's the Holy Church giving us a gift, which is for our salvation. So what is the gift that we are being given, that we are being offered today? You know, 2 weeks ago, we heard the gospel about Zacchaeus. Clearly, obviously, it's about repentance, about Zacchaeus' repentance before the Lord for all the terrible things that he's done. Then last week, we heard the gospel of the publican and the Pharisee. Again, the publican is held out as an example of repentance that we are to emulate. So we're already beginning to kind of get into this repentant path, which is good, because that's what Great Lent is principally about. And so today, as I mentioned previously, maybe even if we never had that time away from God's church, we identify very easily with the son, that prodigal son, who went away and spent all his father's living, as it says in the beautiful King James Version, on harlots and on not very good living. Let's just put it that way. The point is that we see in him that same repentance when he returns to the Father that we see in Zacchaeus, that we see in the unnamed publican from last week. We have that feeling, we grab at it, that feeling of repentance, and that's not wrong. But there's more to it than just that. There are whole books, many books, written just about this parable. There's an entire catechism, which is written just on this parable. That's how rich it is and important for our salvation. So yes, the son who went and spent all of his father's living on his father's inheritance on riotous living, we identify with him, and we should. And we should see this as an example of repentance, and we should try to emulate it. Not the details of his that life, but his returning to the Father. And in some ways, we could argue that's what all about, what Great Lent is all about, is us returning after having gone away a little bit during the year from God. But we also have to look at the Father. We're not just supposed to see the Father from some sort of spectator point of view. Oh, that's nice. Look, the Son took some steps towards the Father. The Father ran right out to him. How nice is that? That's nice. But what does it mean to us? Yes, God will accept us if we just take some steps towards him. He will reach his hand down to grab ours. Yes, absolutely. But we're also supposed to emulate the Father in this parable. Sometimes when we hear a parable and we see God's part in it, we sort of say, well, that's not for me, because I'm not God. True. We are not God. But we are also to emulate the extreme forgiveness and love, the mercy of the Father that we see in today's parable. And then we can go away with that. Because that other stuff about the other son doesn't matter. Of course, that's not true. It does matter. We have to look at that part too. Because everything is good. The son who wasted all of his father's inheritance, he came back, the father forgave him, the party begins, the fetid calf is brought, the best robe is brought, a ring is put on his finger, so on and so forth. But that's not the end. If that's all that we were to know, then that would be the end of the parable that the Lord told. But it's not. Now comes the elder son. And this, brothers and sisters, if we're honest, and we're not usually honest, but let's be honest today, this is really more us. Right? Here's some poor person made some bad decisions, and now they made one good decision to come back to God. And we're kind of like, well, I've been here the whole time. Like, where you been? Where you been? I've been doing all this stuff here. You know, we're keeping the church going, and all this is going on. You show up, and you expect everything to just be there for you. Well, we fall into that pit of the older son, of thinking not about the salvation of the younger son, but about ourselves. Because if we are honest, we're selfish, we're self-centered, and we don't really think about other people very much at all. That's not just us personally, that's our whole society. We're not off the hook because the society does that. But that's the way our society is, and therefore we are infected by this. And so we often play the part of the older son. You know, we are sort of, the father is running out to meet the prodigal, and the older son is sort of standing behind tapping his foot like, you know, where you been? I've been doing all the work. For us, brothers and sisters, this gospel provides three important examples in our preparatory time for Great Lent. This gospel was put on this Sunday because it's understood that the faithful are gathering in the churches now to prepare themselves for the holy days of the Great Lent, which is approaching. And so this teaching is for all of us to emulate the repentance of the prodigal, to emulate the love, mercy, and especially the forgiveness of the Father, and to not emulate the judgmental, high-handed approach of the Son who is already there with the Father. Those are three things that we are being given to help us in our spiritual lives this week and into Great Lent. To strive more for repentance, to strive more for forgiveness, and to strive more to not fall into that position of the older son as judge, jury, and executioner of the sinners in our lives. First and foremost, probably, ourselves. We could repeat this in any number of ways, ad nauseum, but it's not necessary. The lesson is clear from the parable. Now it's up to us, brothers and sisters, not to just look at it as some kind of interesting abstract, but to see it as orders for us for action, to repent more zealously, to forgive more zealously, and to more zealously try to avoid that position of the older son. If we can do that, brothers and sisters, then today we've heard the good news of salvation, the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. We follow this, we follow the Lord. We follow the Lord, we go to the heavenly kingdom. May the Lord grant this to all of us. Amen.
Oh. and of glory and thanksgiving and worship to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto the ages of ages. Under the shelter of thy wings, remove far from him his former delusion, and fill him with the faith, hope, and love which are in thee, that he may know that thou art the only true God, with thine only begotten Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, and thy Holy Spirit. Enable him to walk in all thy commandments, and to fulfill these things which are well-pleasing unto thee. For if a man do those things, he shall find life in them. Inscribe him in thy book of life, unite him to the flock of thine inheritance, that thy holy name may be glorified in him, together with that of thy beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, and of thy life-creating Spirit. Let thine eyes ever regard him with mercy, and let thine ears hearken unto the voice of his supplication. Make him to rejoice in the works of his hands, and in all his generation, that he may give thanks unto thee in worship, and glorify thy great and exalted name, and praise thee continually all the days of his life. For all the hosts of heaven praise thee, and thine is the glory, of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen. Now, brothers and sisters, we will serve a short maleven to St. Vladimir. In keeping with our policy of the parish, that we don't do politics here, we'll be praying for peace in Ukraine, that the Lord will find a path that man perhaps has not been able to see.
Like a merchant seeking a precious pearl, Господи, помилуй,
Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй.
Ищем молимся о стране сего
от всех воинств и всех мир и благочестием живущих в ней.
Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй.
И еще молимся, Богохрани меня в стране России, и о православных людях, и я в Отечестве России несущих, и о спасении.
Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй.
Еще молимся Господу Богу нашему, и же избавите люди свои от врагов видимых и невидимых, наш же утвердитель на мысли братолюбия и благочестия.
Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй.
Будь же молитвенным оком призрите на люди земли украинские и сотворите юни. Непреоборимо, о раз предпорящих, молим Тебя, милосердный Господи, услыши и помилуй.
Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй.
Ой, же просветите светом своего благоразумия, мысли ожесточенных, а мысли ожесточенных, помраченных, верных же своих стране украинской, укрепите. И невредимых соблюсти, молим Тебя все сильные творчи, услыши и помилуй.
Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй.
Давай заповедь Твою нам, еже любить Тебе Бога нашего и ближних Твоего, сотвори до ненависти вражды, обиды, взаимства, кровопролития и прочие беззакония прекратятся. Истинная же любовь да царствует в людях земли украинские. Молимся, Спаситель нас услыши и помилуй.
Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй.
И еще молимся о милости жизни, мире, здравии, спасении, посещении, прощении и оставлении грехов рабов Божьих, братьев, прихожан, святаго храма сего.
Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй.
Обладающих и добродеющих, святимых, стесненных в храме всех, труждающихся, поющих и предстоящих людях, пожидающих от Тебя великие и богатые милости.
Господи, помилуй, Господи, помилуй.
Hearken unto us, O God, our Savior, the hope of the end of the earth, and of those that be afar off at sea, and be merciful, be merciful. O Master, according to thy great mercy, for a merciful God art thou, and the lover of mankind, unto thee do we send up glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
The holy equal of the apostles, great prince, Vladimir, let us pray.
Received holy baptism with the light of divine faith and piety, thou didst illumine the whole land of Russia. Therefore, glorifying and giving thanks to our all merciful Creator and Savior, we glorify and give thanks also unto thee, our enlightener and Father, for through thee have we come to know the saving faith of Christ, and have been baptized in the name of the all holy and most divine Trinity. By this faith have we been delivered from the just condemnation of God, from everlasting bondage to the devil and the torments of hell. By this faith have we received the grace of adoption by God, and the expectation to inherit the blessedness of heaven. Thou art our first leader to the Lord Jesus Christ, the author and accomplisher of our everlasting salvation. Thou art the fervent intercessor and mediator for the Russian land and all its suffering and oppressed people. Our tongue is unable to describe the magnitude and exalted height of the benefactions poured forth by thee upon our land, our fathers and forefathers, and also on us unworthy though we are. O our all-good Father and enlightener, look down upon our infirmities, and entreat the all-merciful King of Heaven, that he be not exceeding wroth with us, even though in our weakness we sin all the days of our life, that he not destroy us in our iniquities, but that he have mercy and save us in his mercy, that he plant in our hearts the saving fear of him, that he illumine our mind with his grace, that we may understand the ways of the Lord, may forsake the paths of impiety and error, and hasten along the paths of salvation and the truth. of the determined fulfillment of the commandments of God and the precepts of the Holy Church. Entreat God, who loveth mankind, O all kind-hearted one, that he increase upon us his great mercy, that he deliver us from the invasion of enemies, from internal strife, sedition, upheavals, from famine, deadly plagues, and from every evil, that he grant us seasonable weather and fertility of the earth, that he preserve and save our most pious nation from all the wiles and assaults of the enemy, that he grant it victory over the adversary and fulfill all its good desires, that he defend its might with wise and faithful servants and maintain righteousness and mercy among its judges and governors, that he grant to our pastors zeal for the salvation of their flock and assistance to all men to conduct their affairs virtuously, to have love one another and oneness of mind, and to struggle faithfully for the good of their homeland and the Holy Church, that he shine forth the light of the saving faith in our land unto the uttermost ends thereof, that the unbelieving may turn to the true faith, that all heresies and schisms may be abolished, and that living thus in peace on earth, we may be counted worthy with thee of the blessings of heaven, praising and exalting God supremely forever.
Not going to help anybody, but it's going to hurt you. So
social media has been given to us as a special kind of cross that our forefathers never had. If you understand the way that the algorithms work, you understand that it's meant to go to extremes. This is a perfect opportunity for that to happen and for us not to do that. So, let's review again. If you see something that you'd like to post on social media, sleep on it, think about it, pray about it, and then don't post it. Post something that has to do with just peace, and you will always be in the right place. Or delete your account, Father Colin says, yes. You know, an old priest once told me, actually I heard him answer a question, can we watch TV, Father, during the Great Lent? And he said, sure, just don't turn it on. And I think social media could be the same thing. You look at the computer all you want, but don't turn it on. So anyway, I'm imposing that upon you, but it's maybe not the worst idea ever. And again, whenever there is something like this happening, which unfortunately is all too regular, in our parish, we don't do politics. Everybody's welcome here. This is one of the few places in the world, I think, where Ukrainians and Russians and Americans all get together in the same place at the same time every week, and it's not for a battle. It's it is for a battle to fight against the demons, but it's for our opportunity to save our souls together, and I think we have to continue to strive for that. We ask you to stay with us afterwards, brothers and sisters, for our meal. We ask a donation of $7 for adults, $4 for students, guests, and children eat free. Let's again work hard on getting those guests who were not here last week to go first. We need to keep the kids back a little bit. Guests should be eating first. Let's continue to work on it. It's also our annual sisterhood meeting today. All the sisters are welcome and urged to participate. Our annual meeting is next Sunday. Please see our membership coordinators today to join. It's very important to become a member of our parish. It shows those around us, for instance, in our township and our county, the size and strength of our parish. Our two membership coordinators are Constantine Gunnius, who's raising his hand now. I saw Dima before, but no, he seems to... So there he is. There he is. He's hiding there by Katya. So you can see Dimitri or Constantine today if you have questions about that, to renew your membership or to begin your membership if you haven't yet become a member. We continue to have our mask recommendation here in the parish, which is more of a recommendation of not judging your fellow believers. Really like the son of the prophet in the parable today. Whoever is doing something other than you needs prayers, not judging. It's house blessing time, and we will continue to bless in the fifth week of Great Lent, I'm sure. Not that many people have come forward yet. The disease is dying down greatly. Father Colin and I know how to wear masks. I'm much better looking in a mask. I'd be happy to wear a mask if I come to your house. So please do not hesitate. It's important to have the house blessed. Many people did not have it done last year because of the pandemic. It's not good to just put this up year after year after year. I want to thank everybody who covered, especially Father Colin, while I was gone this week. It seems like whenever I leave, things get really, really busy. And so Father Colin got a lot of blessings this week. He got to do his first funeral, got to do his first funeral in Slavonic. Got to do a lot of other things this week because I was gone. And so thank you, Father, for your hard work. And everyone else who helped to make sure that everything got taken care of while I was gone. Parish Church School registration is open online. You can also see Alexandra Perishinkle, who is here somewhere today. There she is sitting down. If you'd like to know more about that. And our Orthodox Classical Academy, our work continues and will continue during Great Lent. We'll be doing a lot of work then, so please look for the call from the Brotherhood. We'll also be happy to have sisters helping us as we continue to work on the interior of the project. Fasting this week is Wednesday and Friday. This is the last kind of regular fasting week that we have until well after Pascha. So please have a look at the calendar so that you're able to follow the fasts appropriately as they get a little bit unusual at this time of year. Cemetery spaces are available. When we had the funeral this week, we buried another person there, a young man named Vladimir. Please remember him in your prayers, and we'll pray for him all during these 40 days after his repose. Special services and activities this week, Tuesday evening, 6 o'clock, Wednesday morning, 8 o'clock, that's for Higher Minor Harolampus, then Wednesday evening, Agapis, 6 o'clock, Friday evening, 6 o'clock, and 8 o'clock on Saturday morning, the first Soul Saturday of the Great Lenten cycle will be taking place, and then Saturday and Sunday, as usual. Other announcements before, yes, Deborah.
So, next Sunday, we're
going to
have relief. So ladies, I guess if men want to help with that, please. It's Natasha's group that's doing the main thing, but we all are welcome to help to make crepes, relief. So talk to me if you want a recipe or if you want to bring anything else, just let me know. Thank you.
Good.
And if Brotherhood can set up special like place, I'm thinking maybe let's over there, like maybe in P.
For next week?
For today. We're gonna have a meeting today, so if you can kind of put tables together for us,
good. Other announcements. Catechism on Thursday, 6 o'clock, Vespers and Catechism. Other announcements. All right, we have many years. What's that? Christopher Simeon, who celebrated, I guess, his first name's day today, this week.
Thank you.
Congratulations everyone at the feast. Please stay with us for a meal for the day.